Now we will talk about MRP or Materials Requirement Planning. Now we fairly know that MPS plans for individual products, production plan, but that is just a plan. So there is no execution so far. So to do that execution, we need a systematic scientific way to plan for required raw material, and that answers a requirement of materials requirement planning in the planning systems. Now, what is MRP? MRP is simply a scientific way of determining the requirement of all the raw materials, spares, components, and all other items that are required for production at best possible way. Now, MRP converts master schedule of a final product into a detailed schedule for raw materials and all other items required for production. So simply, MRP takes an input from MPS and it gives certain output for the further execution. Now, what are the objectives of MRP? There are basically three major objectives of MRP. The first is to ensure raw materials are available for production at right time. The second is to maintain the lowest possible material in the inventory, because we have to plan scientifically only about required demand, not in excess and not in shortage. The third objective is to plan for manufacturing activities and delivery schedules and also a purchasing activities. Now let's see how MRP looks like. So typical MRP flow takes multiple inputs, then it processes, which is basically a scientific calculation based on all these inputs, and it gives certain outputs. So what are the different inputs that MRP takes? The first input is bill of material. It is also called as product structure, and it also considers any changes that are done by engineering team. Basically, it is called as engineering design changes. The second input that MRP takes is master production schedule. So master production schedule is basically a production plan that is directly fed into MRP systems. Then the third input of MRP is current inventory records. So in this input, MRP considers all the data factors, all the data aspects about inventory, which includes on-hand quantity of inventory, which includes safety stock that we have to keep for each product, then ordering policies like minimum order quantity, maximum order quantity, also order batches or standard package size. Once all these inputs are taken by MRP, it does scientific calculation and it gives two major outputs. One is plan for purchase orders and second is plan for manufacturing orders. On top of that, MRP also gives some exception reports or planning reports, which talks about if there is any exception in the sequence of production, then this exception report talks about what we have to prepone or postpone in terms of orders, and all these exceptions are helping to make sure that we are on track with the plans. MRP also gives an output in the form of multiple planning report or performance report of the purchasing team or the production team.